In this episode, we're going to fit a solar-powered battery charger for a boat.
Yeah, Euromotive in Carrick and Shannon supplied all the equipment, all the bits and bobs and everything we need.
Not only that, they reckon they've got a solar setup that'll work even in an Irish winter. So we're going to remove these are the old solar panels, and we're going to fit the new ones. Before we remove these, we're going to just check and see how much power are they producing today, the 25th of October, in 5 degrees on a dull overcast sky.
I love the way you say we. I really do.
I'm going to do it. Marion is going to make tea.
That's all.
So we'll see how the new setup then compares. And if Euromotive are to be believed, their solar setup is going to work a heck of a lot better than this.
Yeah, as we say, it's the 25th of October and it is only 5 degrees. It is freezing cold. You can see it's dull and overcast.
Yeah. So we're going to fit new solar panels. These are completely different to the ones that we have here at the moment. These are polycrystalline panels and they're 100 watts. And we're going to fit monocrystalline panels. We're going to be changing everything from the solar panels all the way back to the batteries. So
Harry. Yeah.
So Harry is going to be changing everything from the solar panels to the cabling to the charge controller. And we're going to replace the charge controller with a thing called an MPPT, which is effectively a solar powered battery charger. And everything that we're using is manufactured by Victron. So it's good quality.
Interesting to see.
At the end of the day, the numbers don't lie. So we're going to measure stuff in amps, and I don't even know what amps are, other than to say that they're a unit of measurement. And we're going to see how many amps the old system is producing, and we're going to compare that and see how many amps the new system produces in this weather.
Yeah, come on with us and see Harry fitting all this stuff.
Okay. Okay guys, this is a battery monitor that I have built into the boat. I'm going to use this as a benchmark. We're still using the old system, two 100 watt solar panels. And if you look there at the very bottom, you see 0.4 amps. Just above it, it says charge. So everything on the boat is disconnected. We're not plugged into the mains. And the only item that is running is this battery monitor. And the solar panels at the moment are producing 0.4 of an amp. In other words, just under half of an amp. This is our benchmark. We want to see if our new system is going to beat that. Right, so my first job is to start removing the old solar panels and removing all the wiring that goes along with them. And would you believe it's just starting to rain? That's my luck. So guys, the first issue that I ran into was I had to reuse the brackets from the old solar panels. And the reason I had to do this was I had to mount my solar panels quite high in order to accommodate this air horn. There's an old air horn on the boat that I didn't really want to remove. So I had to raise the solar panels up quite high and I had to make special plates to keep them that high. Now I have the solar panels inside in the boat, the new ones. So I'm just going to bring this in and offer it up, make sure that it fits. So that's... yep, that's gone. It's a little bit big, which is great because I can tighten that in and they'll hold those new solar panels. Okay, I crack on with getting three more of these made up. So you can see that the arms that I made up to hold the solar panels are a little bit short. But luckily, I'm putting them down with these self-tapping heads, so I don't need to re-drill holes. I can just... drill them in like that. A lot to be said for those self-tappers, they are a lifesaver. So then these get secured onto those blocks and will sit round about there and they'll hold these new wider solar panels. Okay guys, here is my wiring diagram and I hope you're going to like it. So we start off here at the bottom left hand corner. This is the battery and you see the plus and minus terminals on it. Then we have the MPP charge controller with the input on one side and the output on the other side. And over here we have the two solar panels. So this is how I set it up. First of all, I connect the battery to the MPPT. That's those two connections there. Then I connect the positive of this solar panel
to the negative of this solar panel. Then I take the positive of this fella, I connect it to the MPPT, and I take the negative of this fella and connect that to the MPPT. Remember that both of those cables are high voltage and both of them need to be the same length. Another point to remember is that the MPPT needs to be located as close as possible to the battery, because the run from the MPPT to the battery is 12 volt, not high voltage.
Bit of an update. I have the two solar panels, there they are, bolted into place. I'm still keeping them covered up with a bit of cardboard because I haven't got them connected to the charge controller or the battery yet. So the next thing is to run the cables from these two solars down through here and into the boat. Then we'll fit the solar charger and we connect all that up. And just to put things into perspective, guys, these are the cables that we're using, that supplied. They're Victron cables. Those are the cables that were on the old solar panel. See, look at the difference. So from what I do know of it is that in order to get solar working properly in Ireland, you need to have all your ducks in a row. You can get away with it if you're in Spain or Australia. It doesn't really matter if you have a couple of ducks out of the way, you're still going to get a good charge off your solar. But to do it here in Ireland, everything has to be right. It's a good idea to put a little mark on the cable so you know which one is a positive and which is a negative when you get the cables inside. That little mark will tell me.
Now this is, I don't know whether you can see it or not, the holes he's putting into my beautiful boat. Well, he keeps telling me it's going to be worth it.
Yeah. The noise you can hear in the background is the diesel heater. And we have that on because I want to run the batteries down. And but I also need to make connections where this is going to go onto the battery. So I need to make another connection the same as this. So heat it all up with a blowtorch.
Some people out there are probably horrified, Harry, that you're doing this.
There's some people in here that are horrified
so am I.
That I'm doing this. And, so I'm just melting the solder into it. That's good. That'll be quite hot for quite a while.
Right, so even looking at the cables, the old cable is the red one, and look how beefier the new cables are, right? And as I say, the charge controller, old one, new one. All the ducks are in a row.
So you may remember from the sketch we did earlier on that we have high power leads and we have the 12 volt leads. So I just like to label these leads so that in 2 or 3 years' time when I'm pulling out the seating and I come across them, I know exactly what they are. So I'm labeling these high power solar negative and high power solar positive. And then on the other side, the charge controller, the leads going to the battery, I've named them 12 volt solar negative and 12 volt solar positive. It just makes it a little bit easy for me later on.
Oh, right, so an update.
Good day's work.
Well, yeah, a hard day's work. I didn't start the job of putting on the solar panels till about midday, thereabouts.
Would have been 1 o'clock, half one evening.
Yeah, but and in Ireland, the end of October, it gets dark pretty quick. So unfortunately, by the time I had the solar panels installed, I had the charge controller installed and all the wiring done in between, the sun was gone over the horizon. So we have to wait till tomorrow to see how well they perform.
Okay guys, so we're jumping forward here a couple of weeks. And the main thing was, the next day we went in to check and see how many amps was the new solar system producing, and was producing 4.3 amps. Now, I'll grant you, it was slightly brighter that day than it was the day before. We had the time the same. We timed it so that we would, the original reading we took was the 0.4 amps. That was at about midday. So we waited until midday the following day to try and get as good a comparison as we could.
Yeah, it seems to be working very well.
So 4.3 amps is more than we were getting in the middle of the summer, okay?
Which is mighty, like, really, isn't it?
It is. Yeah. Now, that said, word of caution, this is not scientific, okay? We can't say how bright it was the day before compared to how bright it was this day. We can't compare how thick the cloud was or how thick the cloud was not.
It's okay. Won't harm you. Say hello to the camera. Thank God you're a brave little fella, aren't you?
Isn't he beautiful?
He's so brave. So, I hope you can see this.
This is
just a little robin that we happened to meet when we were going out for a walk. And he's just so brave. Anyway.
Oh, he's gorgeous.
Right, so the thing I would say is that there's certainly enough charge from those solar panels to keep your batteries maintained over the winter if you're just leaving your boat and you don't want to plug into the mains. Yep, it'll certainly do that. It'll be very, very good for your batteries actually as well. If you're staying on board the boat and you're using your diesel heating and you're using an electric fridge, then no, it's not going to be able to cope with that in the winter month.
At home, you'd have to have electricity to start all those kinds of things, you know.
I know, I mean, you wouldn't expect to run it off a solar panel.
No, yeah. You wouldn't. I mean, we know people that have solar panels on their house and they still have to put on the
electricity. Of course, still have to use amounts. But look, during the summertime, I've no doubt whatsoever that, it would be absolutely superb, because we know from the old system we were getting, it was just about coping, and this is going to be an awful lot better. The other thing we noticed is that as soon as November came, the sun went lower in the sky. The shadows got longer. Where our boat is moored, we're surrounded on all sides by trees and we're kind of right down in a valley. So our horizon is actually quite high. So we didn't get sun for too many hours each day.
No. And if you're moored, just say we're up in Ballinamore, okay? Mm-hmm. And you're saying we're in trees. Like, we're way down in the valley.
Well, we are.
Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
So
this, I mean, it's a very high horizon that we have. And that, things like that affect it quite a bit. We were probably only getting quality sun for maybe an hour or two. And when I say sun, I mean this kind of sun, dull, overcast sky. Occasionally we did get a blue sky, as you do in Ireland every once in a while in the middle of winter. But
would you recommend
these? Yeah. Without a doubt. I mean, look, the sums don't lie. Look, the numbers you have on the screen there, on the left-hand side, you have the 0.4 amps. That's what we were getting before with the old system on the 25th of October, I think it was. The one on the right-hand side is the next day at the same time. It is more than a tenfold increase. And as I've cautioned before, and I'll say it again, okay, I can't say it was duller the next day. It was a little bit brighter, certainly, but it wasn't beaming sunshine.
Well, it's December now. Give us a recap. What do you think?
Okay, well, when I checked the battery monitor this morning, we were getting sort of 1.4, 1.5 amps. That was before 11 a.m. in the morning.
Very good.
Again, it's a dull, overcast day, as you can see. So I think, that's pretty good. I'm, very, very happy with it.
Okay. So is there different types of solar panels, Harry?
Yeah, what we have is, the old ones we had were called polycrystalline panels. I hope I'm pronouncing that correctly. And what we've replaced them with now are monocrystalline panels. And generally, from what I understand of it, is if you're living in Portugal or Australia or any kind of sunny climate, it doesn't really make much odds which you use. If you're living here in Ireland, you need to use the monocrystalline panels.
Okay.
That's my understanding of it.
All right.
That's what we've done with it.
Now, can I just ask you, right, do you know the little gadget thingy that you have on your phone?
Oh, the app, yeah.
Oh,
that's amazing. Glad you said that. There's an app that goes with the Victron MPPT charge controller. So you can look on your phone and you can see exactly what is going into the batteries at any time. You can also go back through the history. So you can see what kind of charge was being put in, whether it was, what level of charge, whether it was float or, I think there's three different settings, I'm not really sure what they are. But so you can look back in the app, you can see the history of that, how much has gone in, how many kilowatt hours they've actually put into the batteries. And another interesting thing you can do is when it's dull weather, and you might actually hear the rain outside as it's chucking it down, it's just miserable weather. When it's bad weather like this, you don't really get a proper charge coming in on the panel. So what the MPPT charge controller does is it'll save up the electricity, then it puts it through in a pulse. You can actually see on the screen when it puts those pulses in.
Okay, now another question I'm going to ask you.
Yeah.
Can you access that app from anywhere? Or do you have to be beside the
That's the only
system?
Drawback I would see with the app is that it's a Bluetooth app, so it'll work for me here on the boat. It'll work within about a 15 meter radius of the charge controller itself. So you can't, unfortunately, look at it at home.
Okay.
Which would be nice to be able to do. That's maybe the next thing. But
It's a nice little gizmo to have, and it's good to be able to see it on the boat.
As I say, men, boys with their toys.
Yeah, well, everything has an app nowadays. But the other thing is, we did notice a slight difference between what the app would say it's producing in the solar panels are producing and what our monitor would say. There was a difference of about 0.6 of an amp. There's probably a number of reasons for it. First of all, the charge controller is measuring the output from the charge controller, whereas the battery monitor that we have is measuring the output at the batteries. And it also has to make a calculation for the fact that that battery monitor itself uses a certain amount of electricity. So there's probably, you know, there's a wee bit of a discrepancy between the two, but only about a little over just half of one amp. So that's not enough to make any great difference. There.
If there's any book, is there any book that you can buy to read up on these?
Well, the one that you see me reading is
Is
Solar and 12 Volt Power for Beginners by a guy called George Eccleston. It's a fantastic read. There's no fluff in it. There's no bull in it. It is a really good read, and it's well worth getting. And I put a link in the description below to, if you want to purchase that book. It's, I'd say, well worth getting. When I was mounting these panels now, I had to reuse the old mounts, and the reason for that is because we'd stuff up on the roof. I'd there was an old air horn that's actually now mounted underneath the solar panel, and I didn't want to remove that. To remove it, I'd have to remove all the panels on the inside of the roof. To remove the panels on the inside of the roof, I'd first have to remove the panels off the walls.
And we wouldn't be talking.
It was just too much hassle. So I've reused the old brackets, and I've raised the panels, so they're about 4 inches up off the deck. But if you're doing it, you won't necessarily need to do that. It's just that it was particular to our boat that we had the air horn sitting underneath the solar panels. So that's why we had to use those brackets. The other thing we don't have, and because of the layout of the boat, is we weren't able to tilt our panels. If you could tilt those panels, you would, again, up your amperage quite a bit. So if you're thinking of setting them up, I would say have a look at somewhere that maybe you could mount them so that they can be tilted.
Right,
just to direct them towards the sun, and it gives you much more amps. Yeah, so you remember the old charge controller we had with the original system, and then with the new system, we have the MPPT charge controller. And from just reading up on it, MPPT charge controller seem to be about 20 to 30% more efficient than the older one. So it's, again, it's all these little things that seem to, once you have everything right, you seem to get quite a good output from those
and they
panels.
Are working very well.
They are.
You
as
know,
I say,
they really are.
You wouldn't be able to live on the wilds off grid using just your solar panels. Certainly not just two of them.
Yeah.
But to keep your batteries charged over the winter, yeah, absolutely no problem whatsoever. They will certainly do that. And during the summertime, yeah, they will.
Yeah.
We'd have no problem going to a port and not having a hookup for electricity.
So, guys, there you go. Again, 3.7, I'm just going to say 3.7 amps, has gone to 3.8 amps. And this is a stormy, rotten day. Look at that, we've gone to 3.9. More than we were getting at the height of the summer.
So there you go. You can see how terribly dull and cloudy it is today. And yet, we're still getting, what do we say, nearly 4 amps. I'm really delighted with that. That's excellent. All the Victron equipment that we used in this video was supplied by a company in Carrigachan called Euromotive, and we've a link to their brand new website in the description just below.
So once again, we hope you've enjoyed this video as much as Harry has enjoyed making it, and I made loads of tea.
You did. I think I got about 5 cups of tea. I was out in the rain putting all these in. It was just a miserable day, and yeah, that's all you could do was sort of bring up cups of tea to me, really, wasn't
that's
it?
All, yeah.
It was just miserable weather.
Yeah.
But guys, if you haven't subscribed to the channel yet, please think about clicking on that subscribe button, hit the notification bell, and then YouTube will send you a notification as soon as our next video is out.
So, thanks for watching. Cheerio.